what we may see as bad situations, as long as we have the Lord on our side, everything will be all right. Amen. So we ask that you would pray with us as we sing this song. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation. I've been purchased by God. I've been born of His Spirit and washed in His blood. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my side. Angels descending, they bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. Now this is my story. Do you have a story to tell today? This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Hallelujah! This is my story. This is all the day long. You mind if I sing that one more time? This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior. That you would go with us to Exodus, the 13th chapter. Exodus, the 13th chapter. And we will read in your hearing verses 14 through verses 16. Amen. Exodus 13, 14 through 16, giving all praise and all honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Respects once again to the angel of this house, Pastor Windsor L. Archie, and Sister Archie in their absence, to Minister Searcy and to Minister Leela McNary and to Minister Wallace McNary and to each and every one of you here today. And we thank God for seeing the junior ushers. It took me back to the 80s when I too were a junior usher. and learn how to stand at the door and work for our Lord. And it's just beautiful to see children and young people still working for the Lord in this day and age. Because there are so many children that would rather be anywhere else than in the house of the Lord. So I honor you as well today. So now, let us read. It says, "And it shall be when thy son asketh thee in time to come, saying, What is this? That thou shalt say unto him, By strength of hand, the Lord brought us out from Egypt, from the house of bondage. And it came to pass when Pharaoh would hardly let us go, that the Lord slew all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both the firstborn of man and the firstborn of beasts. Therefore I sacrifice to the Lord all that openeth the matrix, being males, but all the firstborn of my children I redeem. And it shall be for a token upon thine hand, and for frontlets between thine eyes. For by strength of hand the Lord brought us forth out of Egypt." And for a few moments this morning, for a subject and for a tag, we ask that you would pray with us and think on the thought, stepping out.
Stepping out.
Amen. Stepping out. Amen. The other night, my wife and I, who I always honor, Sister Alicia Archie. Amen. My rock, my sugar lump. The other night, we were sitting watching a movie, and the movie was called Otherhood. And in this movie, it was a movie about three women who became friends because their sons were friends. And the sons had moved from the little town that they lived in to the big city of Manhattan. And the sons had begun to forget about their mothers on Mother's Day. And it just so happened this Mother's Day, the mothers decided that they were going to go to Manhattan and surprise their sons. And one of the mothers was played by the great actress Angela Bassett. And for years, her husband had passed away. And she stayed exactly the same. She stayed conservatively the same way because he liked her hair a certain way. And she wore clothes the way she did because he liked them a certain way. But when she got to Manhattan, she decided that it was maybe a time for her to step out of her usual way of doing things. And when she got there, she went to the beautician and got her hair done a different way. And she started wearing her clothes a different way. And her friend started looking at her and said, "You know, you just look so much younger and so much different than you did when you were always staying in your comfort zone." And because of her coming out of that comfort zone, she began doing many more things. She started painting again, and she decided to sell the house and move to France. And she did so many different things. And sometimes we as Christians need to learn how to step out of our comfort zone. Am I right, somebody? Too many times we want to stay where it's easy. It's, you know, where we always are doing the same thing the same way. But see, Moses was trying to get the children of Israel to understand that it was time for them to step out in faith on God. Do I have some witnesses here? Because see, the Bible lets us know that the children of Israel had known about how God had taken care of Abraham. They knew how God had taken care of Isaac and Jacob. But see, they had never had God to take care of them the way that he was about to take care of them. They had never had the need to trust in him in the way that he wanted them to trust in him and the way that he was going to provide for them. See, we have to understand that it is now time for us to realize that God is our provider. We as Christians sometimes want to think that it's all on us. We forget that God is our provider. He is our way maker. He is our heart fixer. He is our mind regulator. And God is giving somebody this word today. I don't know who it's for. But God is giving this word today that it's time to step out on faith. And know that he is God. And know that everything will be all right if you just trust in him. Do I have some witnesses here today? Because I found out, I don't know about you, but I have found out for myself that by stepping out on faith, there's a few things that we do. See, when we step out on faith, y'all, we conquer fear. See, the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man, right? But in the power of God. And see, the children of Israel had to gather that because what? They had been in slavery how long? 430 years in Egypt. Am I right, Bible readers? They saw Egypt as a place of comfort. They said, yeah, you know, when they got out there into the wilderness, why, Moses, why did you bring us out? We could have stayed in Egypt and we may have been slaves, but at least we would have still been in our comfort zone. But see, they were fearful of going and doing the thing that God had told them to do. They wanted to stay where it was easy. And see, sometimes when God tells us something to do, it's not going to be easy, y'all. See, he took them through the wilderness. The scriptures, if you keep on going, you'll find out that in verse 18, God led them through the wilderness for a reason. They could have went through the land of the Philistines and it would have been a lot easier and a lot quicker. But he said, I'm going to take them through the wilderness because they might want to repent. In other words, they might want to turn around and go back to Egypt. And I want to see how good and how willing they are to really go the way that I want them to go and go through the situations that I need for them to go through. And see, when we have fear, that means what, y'all? We are lacking faith. But the Bible tells us God has not given us the spirit of fear. So see, us as Christians, we shouldn't be fearful when the Lord wants us to go and do what he wants for us to do. We should just be willing to say, Lord, here am I. Hallelujah. Send me. Because there is a special reward for if you overcome. Am I right, y'all? Because Revelations 2:7 tells us that those that overcome will be able to do what? Eat from the tree of life. And I don't know about y'all, but I don't want to end up dying and going to hell after living in hell. When I have the opportunity to overcome. So that means whatever you're going through in life, don't let it keep you down. Your job might not be the job that you want to have, but just keep on just serving the Lord. Situations in your life might not be where you want them to be. Your children may not be doing the things that you want them to do. And life might just be hard right now. But I've come to learn and find out for myself that if you just keep faith in the Lord and don't have fear in your heart and let him be God, he will bless you to overcome. Hallelujah. And when we step out on faith, not only are we conquering fear, but then we are pleasing God, aren't we? What does Hebrews tell us? But without faith, it is what impossible. Look at somebody and say impossible. It is impossible to please him. Why? Because he who comes to him must believe that God is who he says he is. So what you're trying to say, preacher? Well, I'm glad you asked that question. Because, see, you have to believe that God is Jehovah Jireh. That means that if you believe that God is Jehovah Jireh, you have to understand that he's going to provide for you in every situation. Your pockets might be thin right now, but as long as you trust in God, he will provide for you. Like the Bible says, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. So all we have to do is realize that God is our provider. We also have to believe that he is Jehovah Rapha. If you're going through some sickness, if you're going through pain, if you're going through some problems or diseases, just know that God is your healer. You have to believe that he is your healer. You have to believe that he is Jehovah Shalom. You have to know that he is your peace throughout every storm that you must go through. And when you know who God really is, it says that what? He is a rewarder of them that do what? Diligently seek him. See, there are too many of us that don't diligently seek the Lord. We want to do things in our way. We want to do things in our time. We want to do things the way we've been doing them for 111,000 years. But see, when God tells us to do something differently, that means we have to diligently seek him in everything that we do. That doesn't mean just seek him when you come to the church house, y'all. That means we need to seek him in our daily life. When we're on our way to the job, when we're dealing with our children, when we're dealing with our husbands and wives, when we're riding up and down the street, we need to diligently seek him. Why? Because he says, when you seek me, rewards come. Rewards come. Blessings flow. So see, when you have him on your side, you don't have to worry about bad situations going on, because they might go on for a while. The Bible tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but I'm so glad that joy is going to come in the morning. So you might be going through night right now. You might be shedding a few tears. You might be weeping every now and again, but all you have to do is diligently seek him and watch and see if joy won't come in the morning. Oh, hallelujah. Then when we step out on faith, we are also being obedient to God. Amen? The Bible tells us in Romans, but now is made manifest, and by the scriptures of the prophets, according to the commandment of the everlasting God, made known to all nations for the obedience of faith. So when you obeying, that means you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. When God tell you to go out and get out from in these beautiful walls and go and talk to people and let them know that he is God. And beside him there is none other. That's what you're supposed to do. And you're going to do it in faith. When he tells you to step out on faith and change some things that you've been doing in your life so that you might be able to bring them in from the field of sin, then we don't say, well God, this is the way mom and daddy told me how to do it. We've been doing it like this for all my life. This is the traditional way of doing it. If you've been obedient to God, God said, sometimes I'm tired of the tradition. Didn't he say it? He said, I'm tired of the rams. I'm full of rams. I'm tired of your bullocks. I don't want none of that no more. Come to me with something new. Come to me with something different. And see, if you obeying God, you're going to trust him, aren't you? Regardless if it may seem like you walking toward a brick wall, you're going to still trust God, aren't you? Because I heard that he can open doors that no man can shut. And then he can shut doors that no man can open. So it doesn't matter what the situations in front of you may look like, y'all. Just keep on trusting God. Because I found out a long time ago that he'll make ways out of nowhere. He will do things that no man can do. Because see, God specializes. And he's not like anybody else. He's not like man, is he? See, we have to accept God's will. Because sometimes we as Christians, and we're supposed to know it. But sometimes we don't even want to accept God's will. We'll have a family member or something that's down and sick. And we pray for that family member. And then God called that family member home. We the first ones with our lips stuck out. Man, God, why didn't you save my family member? God, I've been praying for him. I did, and you told me that you were a healer. But see, we have to understand God's will is not our will. God's ways are not our ways. God's thoughts are not our thoughts. And we just have to understand that as long as he's in control, we can trust his will. How many of you ready to trust his will really today? To say, Lord, I'm going to let go and let you be in control. Because when we do that, we also can believe God. Because the Bible tells us God's not man that he would lie, huh? Man will lie to you each and every day. He'll look at you right in the face and smile at you and be lying just as quick as sure as they're born. But see, God not going to do that. If God say, if I'm for you, I'm more than the whole world against you, well, you better believe that that's the way it is. If God says that you might have to go through some things, but everything is going to be all right, you better believe it. If you can trust in him, he will make a way out of no way. Because see, I found out for myself that once you conquer fear, that once you please God, that once you are obedient to God, then the blessings flow. Amen, amen. The blessings will flow. Ephesians 1, 3 and 4 says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if you look in the New International Version, it says, praise be the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ, according as he has chosen us in him before the foundations of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. So what's the saying we've always heard all our life? When the praises go up, hey, the blessings come down. So it's letting us know that once we have truly praised God, once we have faithfully stepped out in his word to do what we are supposed to do, then we can find a true power source. Think about it. When you have a power source, what ends up happening? There's a surge in it. There's a charge. When you plug an appliance into that power source, what ends up happening? It ends up coming on. It ends up being able to be used. And see, that's what God wants for us today. He wants for us to plug into him so that he can be our power source, so then he can use us in whatever way he wants to use us. Am I right, somebody? See, I know that when he's your power source, he will make a way out of no way. He will guide you in the right directions that you are supposed to go. And see, when he's your power source, he'll be that light in darkness. He'll give you the power to be able to fight the wiles of the devil. Am I right, somebody? Because Satan is going to always be at us. He's always trying to knock us down. He's going to and fro, trying to devour. But when we have God as our power source, we can be just like Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan. We can have the power to put Satan where he's supposed to be, under our feet. Because see, we can't do it by ourselves, y'all. Human beings don't have that power. We don't have the power to fight Satan by ourselves. But when we let God be our power source, when we let him flow through us, we can fight every situation off and know that it's all going to be all right, because he is our way maker. And also, when we know that he is our power source and the blessings are beginning to flow, then we know that there are some rewards. Am I right? See, the Bible also tells us in Ephesians that there are some rewards. The rewards are that he chose us before the foundations of the world, didn't he? The rewards are that he gave us grace. Am I right, somebody? We've been redeemed through the blood of Jesus Christ. See, that's a beautiful thing, isn't it? Because we don't have to worry about dying in our sins. But because of Jesus, who hung, bled, and died on Calvary's cross, we have a right to the tree of life. Then not only did he die, not only did he shed his blood to cover our multitudes of sins, but then he rose with all power of heaven and earth in his hands. And because of that, we know one day he's going to come back to receive us again, isn't he? And if we have stepped out and done the things that he wants for us to do, we understand that everything is going to be all right. And I don't know about you, but I want to be where the spout of blessings are flowing. You know, there was a time in my life when I was younger that I wished that I could have had a spout of my favorite adult beverage.
that was flowing every day where I wanted it. But now I want the spout of blessings to flow all over me. I want them to rain down like showers, because the Bible lets us know that there is a fountain that is filled with blood and is drawn from Emmanuel's vein. And whoever plunged beneath that flood, it says, lose all, lose all, lose all thy guilty stain. So I want to be where the blessings are flowing. How about you today? I want the Lord to shine his light down on me. I want the Lord to hold me up. I want the Lord to keep me straight. I want the Lord to hold my hand while I run this race. I don't want to run this race in vain. I'm gonna step out and do what the Lord wants me to do. That's why sometimes I know that I've been brought up a good Baptist, and I know that what mama and daddy taught me, and I believe that everything is always gonna be all right. But now the Lord has told me to step out on his word, to step out and on his faith, and to do what he wants me to do. Some people may not understand it, but as long, I said as long, as it's all right with me and the Lord, I know that I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. I know where he leads me, I'm gonna follow. So how about you today? Are you ready to leave Egypt? Are you ready to leave your comfort zone? Are you ready to change your life and do what the Lord wants you to do? I know that I am ready. If you are ready, let me see you wave your hand. If you're ready, come on and stand on your feet. If you're ready, give the Lord some praise and say, yeah, yes, oh, oh yeah. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord for stepping out on his word today. In faith. See, we have to do it in faith. You know, none of the great people of the Bible did anything without faith. They had to have faith. Moses had to have faith to know that when God told him to stretch out that rod, that the Red Sea was going to part. Amen. Daniel had to know. He had to have faith that even though he was in the lion's den, he knew that God was going to make it where those hungry lions were not hungry that day. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they said, we're not bound down. We believe we have faith that our God is going to take care of us. But even if he don't, it's still going to be all right, because we're not bound down. And what did Nebuchadnezzar end up finding out? Faith will make it where he'll see four instead of three. In the fiery furnace, walking around, coming out with their clothes, not even singing. That's what'll happen when you step out on faith. And that's what we have to do. So there may be one here today who is out of the ark of safety, who is saying, I know that it's time to step out. Step out on faith and know that God is a way maker. God is a heart fixer. God is a mind regulator. And as this song is being written, we ask that
you would consider coming to the Lord and knowing that he will make a way out of nowhere. All you have to do is trust in him. Though the storms keep on raging in my life, and sometimes it's hard to tell the night from day, still that hope that lies within is reassured. As I keep mine eyes upon that distant shore, I know he'll lead me safely to that blessed place he has prepared. But if the storms don't cease, and if the wind keep on blowing, my soul has been anchored in the Lord. Though the storms keep on raging in my life, and sometimes it's hard to tell the night from day, still that hope that lies deep down within, I'm so glad it's reassured. As I keep mine eyes upon that distant shore, I know he'll lead me safe to that blessed place he has prepared. But if the storm don't cease, and just in case the wind
been anchored, my soul has been anchored, my soul has been anchored.
God bless you. God keep you is our prayer. And we pray you receive something from the word today that'll help you step out in faith and do the things that the Lord would have for you to do. Amen. Amen.